Hello and welcome. Today I have only a short video about a, well, swindle which I fell over some time ago, and also a small preview of a project which I was working on and off for the last months. Long story short, I collected many Hercules MDA, CGA and EGA graphics cards over the years, but I have no way to test them, needless to say to use them. The problem is that all these cards deliver horizontal sync frequencies between 15 and 24 kHz and vertical sync between 50 and 60 Hz. However, in my workshop I have this Samsung TFT monitor, which supports only VGA with horizontal sync above 31 kHz and vertical sync above 60 Hz. Well, about 1 year ago I've been searching for a chip solution to be able at least to test the graphics cards, and I stumbled pretty fast over the very well known GBA's 8200 video converter, which was advertised to support CGA and EGA. For me it was a little bit unfortunate that it didn't say that it supports MDA or Hercules, but I thought at least CGA and EGA could be covered using it. The GBS 8200 is extremely cheap, with something about 20 euros, so I ordered one from China, and after a month of waiting it finally arrived. The board has 15-pin D-sub video inputs, but an EGA and CGA output is usually 9-pin. Whatever, I found a DB9 to D-sub video adapter, connected everything, and nothing worked. I tried different cards and different settings, but nothing helped, so as naive as I am, I thought GBS 8200 has a VGA input, so why just not connect a normal VGA output and see if it works? Nope, it didn't work as well. Then I thought that my converters may be broken, so I ordered another one, and after a month of waiting I got the very same result, no image whatsoever. This was the point where I started to realize that GBS 8200 is not what it seems to be, and especially it is not what it advertises to be. After some investigation I understood that the GBS 8200 in its unmodified state is not a CGA or EGA converter, it simply cannot handle the signals. The advertised features are just a lie, and as far as I know I'm not the only one who fell into this trap. But does it mean that GBS 8200 doesn't work? No, it does work, but it does something different than CGA or EGA to VGA signal conversion. Well, what does GBS 8200 then, you may ask? Living along component input, this device supports only analog RGBS signals with 15 kHz. But what does this mean? RGBS stands for red, green, blue and sync, where the colors are analog values represented with continuous voltage levels, and sync is a composite signal which contains mixed horizontal and vertical sync signals, where horizontal sync must be 15 kHz and vertical sync between 50 and 60 Hz. Good, analog RGBS signal is what GBS 8200 does support, but what is CGA and EGA? Well, the standards are digital RGB-HV signals, where RGB color information is transferred digitally as a bunch of ones and zeros, and horizontal and vertical sync signals are transferred separately. First of all, GBS 8200 doesn't understand digital RGB signals at all, and although GBS 8200 says that it can handle RGB-HV, if you switch through the input settings, well, it doesn't. It literally supports only analog RGB signal with composite sync. And this is why it doesn't work when you try to connect a CGA, EGA or VGA graphics card to GBS 8200. The old CGA and EGA standards, and MDA and Hercules by the way as well, don't deliver analog color signals and don't deliver composite sync signal. VGA on the other hand does deliver analog color signal, but no composite sync signal as well. Furthermore, standard horizontal sync is above 31 kHz, which is also far away from 15 kHz as expected by the GBS 8200. So this is why it is not a CGA nor EGA converter. It is an analog 15 kHz RGBS to standard VGA converter. But how this can be useful? Well, in case you have an Amiga or another retro machine which outputs analog 15 kHz RGBS signal, then GBS 8200 can be very useful. Since most of the VGA monitors don't support RGBS, but need RGB-HV signals, and even if they would, also most VGA monitors don't support any horizontal sync below 30 kHz. These both conversions can be handled with GBS 8200 very well. But then, is GBS 8200 not useful for CGA or EGA signals at all? Yeah, at least not in unmodified state, but there is something we can do about it. In the last months I designed this adapter, which can be added between the GBS 8200 and a MDA Hercules CGA or EGA card and convert digital RGBHV signals into analog RGBS signal, which then can be sent through GBS8200 to any standard VGA monitor. But this is a topic for another day. I think in the next time I will make follow-up videos about this adapter, explain a little bit how it works, and share an open source project with you so you can create such an adapter on your own. If I could wake up your interest, please subscribe and follow me to the next part of this topic soon. And so far, I hope you enjoyed it. Just as always, please don't forget to put your likes, dislikes, and comments below, and I hope to have you on my channel again. Thank you, and goodbye.